We've seen the basics of how to find and use functions. Let's put it to use. We'll create a new project using cargo and open it up in VS Code, just like we've done before. Let's create a function that returns the very last character of a string. We'll call it lastchar. We start with the fn keyword, then the name of the function, then the arguments and their types, then the return type, and finally, the body of the function. With our function body empty, Rust will complain to us that the function says it returns a char, but is actually returning an empty tuple, aka unit. We'll need to fill in the function body. I'll quickly do that with some functionality on strings. There's no need to understand this code fully at this point. Just know it's using a way to access characters of a string and asking for the next one starting from the back of the string. And finally, calling unwrap, which will crash the program if the string was empty and there was no last character. Notice we're not using the return keyword in our function. The last line of our function body is used as the return value of the function. If we need to return a value before the last line of the function, we need to use the return keyword. Let's return the siren emoji character when the string is empty. You might notice we don't end the last line with a semicolon. If we do, Rust will complain and say that we're returning unit instead of a char. Effectively, the semicolon says to not return the value from the last line of code. Since nothing is being returned explicitly, unit is returned. Calling our function should be straightforward. We simply name it and provide any arguments in between open and close parentheses. Rust is complaining here because string literals aren't actually of type capital S string, but are instead a different type. We'll need to turn our string literal into a capital S string type using the string colon colon from function. Once we call it on our string literal, the compiler is happy as we're now passing the right type to our function. With that, we now have experience defining and calling functions.